The following is a Q&A video that I recorded about a year and a half ago, and I'm finally getting around to editing it and putting it up on YouTube. I hope you enjoy.
Hello all, this is Freddie Williams, and welcome to the next part of my Q&A series, the behind the scenes of creating comic books. This question comes from N-O-F-A-C-H-X. No Fox? I don't know. Your computer pen. I noticed when I was watching a video of yours, my comic book demo, there was a cylinder-shaped thing on your computer pen. It looks like it would be more comfortable to use. And how do you use the button on the pen itself, or do you use them at all? Good question, very observant. This is the pen that I use on a regular basis. Hopefully you can see this. It's not very pretty. this is just a bamboo pen, but even whenever I had like an Intuos 4, I was doing the same thing. It's not uncommon for me to work for literally 10 or 12 hours at a stretch sitting at my computer, you know, drawing with the Wacom pen. I would recommend anyone do this. Basically, if you're not using, usually there's like a couple of, you know, a couple buttons up here, and there's a button here too, usually used for the eraser. And I think on the bamboos you can't change this, on the Intuos you can, but it's always the eraser. Here you could like do a right click or, you know, change these buttons to whatever you would want to. So how am I using them now that they're covered? I don't. I just went into my bamboo Wacom properties and disabled those two buttons. And then after that, I wrapped, so I just used tape. The cylinder shaped thing is something I'm not going to show because I think there might actually be a possibility I could patent it later. So I don't want to show off the design. Not that it's super complex, but I just don't want to get into all that. So basically, just to reduce hand fatigue, just make the pen larger that you're holding onto. Because if you're holding a very thin item, especially if you're trying to maintain, you know, kind of tight control when you're drawing, then you can start to, you know, you'd be encouraging cramps in your hands, and after a while you could even develop, you know, wear on those joints or arthritis or something like that. So anything to avoid that. So just for in general comfort and stuff, what I've done is used some, I think it's just like a regular electrical tape. The green stuff here is like electrical tape. And then on top of that, I use some, it's like a plumber's tape. It's like a, feels like a rubber tape kind of. And it's, I used to just use the electrical tape for everything, but in the summer, whenever my hands would sweat, or whenever sometimes it gets kind of humid or whatever, the adhesive or the stickiness of the tape would start to kind of seep out from the edges, and it would make my hands sticky, and I don't like that feeling. So the plumber's tape, the rubber plumber's tape, avoids that. It just has a little bit of a grip. It's easier to hold on to, and it's pretty comfortable, and it doesn't sweat or, you know, exude that stickiness that the electrical tape does. So that's what I'd recommend. Now, what about those buttons? You know, what do I do with the functionality for that? The right click is the thing that I would miss the most. But on a Mac, which is what I use, you can just hold down, I think it's Option or Command. I can't remember. My muscle memory just does it. But or maybe it's Control click. Anyway. You hit one of those modifier buttons, and whenever you click on the screen, it equals a right click. So, you know, I'm not missing out on the right click. Now, my laptop is a PC. It's one of the newer Dell laptops that I just got earlier this year. And so on that, whenever I'm out of town and I'm traveling and working on that, and I, you know, use the wrapped up Wacom pen, and I need to right click, I just use the right click next to the little motion pad or the scroll pad. And it's a little bit, you know, it's a little bit weird, but you get used to it. So I'm not sure what other PC users would want to do, but for Mac, you just use one of those modifier keys and then click, and it gives you a right click, and I get used to that really fast. So I hope that helps. Good questions. Please keep them coming, and stick around for more Q&A series for behind the scenes of drawing comics.